and Monday drunk.
Well, today we're drinking Kona Brewing Longboard Island Lager.
Sick, dude.
Ooh, here's a label. Check it out. Ooh. That's pretty. What's the ABV? How many of these do I need to get lit? The answer is 40 of them. Okay, what are we eating?
And today we're feasting on Jimmy Dean's Biscuit Roll-Ups. This is the sausage, egg, and cheese version.
If you've seen the commercials on the television about these, that voice.
Roll out of bed and into a new kind of breakfast. Introducing Jimmy Dean Biscuit Roll-Ups.
That awesome voiceover, that's our friend Courtney.
Woo, Courtney, woo, Courtney.
Getting paid, getting paid, getting paid, getting paid. Every time it runs, she gets paid. Okay, cool.
Me and her husband Scott were in a improv class together in the early times, the A through E, the dark times.
Who was the better performer?
Oh, Scott for sure, dude. I suck at performing.
Cool. Excited to try these. I've seen the commercial and obviously seen these in the frozen food section many times. We finally picked them up today. As you're seeing some of that sexy B-roll, here's what they kind of look like up close IRL. Just smashed full of stuff.
Yeah, dude.
So flaky. It's like a croissant crust, huh?
This kind of looks like a Pigs in the Blankets.
Yeah, it's like a Pigs in the Blanket on steroids.
Yeah, dude.
Biscuit roll-up, sausage, egg, and cheese, Jimmy Dean's. Cheers.
Cheers.
It's very, like, biscuity on the back end.
There's just a little too much bread for me. It's good bread. Right. I like the flakiness. Like, the flakiness is really good.
Crumbly.
But actually, it's not for me. I know there's a lot of people who would love that, though. Yeah. I'm more of a meat dude. Some people call me meat dude.
They do. I've heard people call them that. It's so dry. Like, we've talked about this with biscuits before. Like, how do you not put some sort of a wetness factor in there, a WF, if you will? Mm-hmm. It needs, and I'm not trying to sell our sauce. You can give me any hot sauce right now or anything, maybe ranch, I don't care. It needs like more, and the more is like a liquid. It's too dry.
We've talked about it before, and I'm gonna say it again. Jimmy Dean, you think about it. Think of a little ketchup packet, but you put some of the Sixer sauce in there. If people open this up, and they get a little bit of this up on there, there's like a little hole here.
You love holes.
I'm gonna try to pour. Oh, I can.
Nice. Look at you.
See that cavern?
Yeah, you got a little sauce cavern.
I poured a bunch of Sixer sauce in there.
Hero. For your birthday, I meant to get you a cape.
Oh.
Because you are. I can be your hero, baby. Enrique Iglesias.
Is that who sang that?
I'm pretty sure.
Nice.
People were like, Ricky Martin or Enrique. Everybody liked the Living La Vida Loca by Ricky Martin, dude. I was an Enrique guy, dude. Enrique all day, dude. These are the things I debated. That's why I had no friends.
That wasn't bad.
No.
You didn't like the bread, I can see.
I'm kind of all set with that.
Did you suck the sausage out of that?
I broke it in half and this is what remained. A cavern of just a crust.
Crust cavern?
It smells like biscuits.
Yeah, not bad. I'm just not a biscuit guy.
I just think that if you're gonna buy frozen breakfast food, biscuits don't heat up well, even in an air fryer.
All right.
Before we go ahead and decide whether or not we actually are giving that a yeah or a nah, let's do a shout out.
Merch out, merch out, merch out! We got a merch store and it's awesome, filled with all kinds of goodies like this shirt. That's our pocket shirt. We also have a number of other versions of the shirt. We got the shirt I have a drink shirt. We got the Sixer sauce. We got koozies. We got Sunny G's. We got stickers. If you want just about gosh darn near anything with Number Six with Cheese's logo on it, you can purchase that from our website at numbersixwithcheese.com.
Somebody commented today at the time of filming this and said, boys can't be doing this much longer. Pretty soon your groins are gonna start looking like they're 70, 80 years old.
Our groins?
And I was so unbelievably offended reading this comment to think that this guy watches all of our content and then goes, these guys have to be just getting the saggiest balls.
Yeah.
That's what somebody commented. I'm gonna show it to you.
I wonder what he thinks happens with our groins.
For some reason, people assume that as you get older and your diet's bad, you're like,
You're gonna
get some sort of a like repercussion happening with your Johnson.
Yeah, nobody wants to get any HDS.
Heavy dick syndrome?
I hate, yeah. I've been trying to avoid it since I was a young teen.
Dude.
You can't keep this up forever, boys. In the next 2 to 3 years, you'll be your lower groin area exploding if you're not in the gym every day. It's manageable if you're in your mid-20s, which he assumes we're in our mid-20s. Thank you. But oh Lord, wait until you get in the 30s. You just look at pizzas like that and your lower groin area makes it look like that of a 78-year-old mom of 8. Mark my words. Holy smoke, like, I'm not even kidding you. Like, this is a comment we got today and I responded, LOL, we're in our 30s and we go to the gym every day. But also, like, I shouldn't have even said that. I should have been like, my groin's fine, man.
I don't think you gain dick weight. I've been trying to gain dick weight.
I think
weight.
He thinks your like balls are gonna sag to the floor or something.
Cause of your diet?
So what am I supposed to do after I eat this? Be like, oh, I gotta go check and get in the mirror.
Does he think groin is a synonym for belly?
And get with my phone and just be like, is it, how's it looking?
I mean, I weigh my dick daily.
Yeah, I slap it on my scale.
I definitely weigh my dick.
Yeah.
But it just doesn't seem to be gaining much. I'm not gaining any dick weight.
You seem to be a little older. Guys in our young 30s like we are, we always, always weigh our dicks. Anyways, we're gonna do some shoutouts.
Fascinating.
I know. Merch shoutout number one goes to a dear, dear fan of the show. He's been around for a while, Mr. Kevin Salmon. Dude, he lives in Scranton, Pennsylvania.
Home of the office.
Anyways, he bought a sticker sheet and Sixer sauce. So a bottle of Sixer sauce, a sticker sheet. That's your one of the easiest ways to get a quick two banger. Your name said, Kevin, thank you.
Ba-ba. And merch out number two goes to a good friend of mine, Mr. Joe Castellanos.
Yeah.
MD.
MD.
Medical doctor. Joel's an awesome, awesome dude. He's in San Diego. He bought Ooh. 3 Sixer sauces. I haven't even talked to him about it. I gotta hit him up and see if he liked them, because this order, this is from long enough ago. He's probably got that, right? Oh yeah, this is from January. I bet Joel got those.
God, I hope so.
Got those Sixer sauces, dude. Hey, Joel, thanks a lot, man, for buying those. Probably not watching this video. You probably watch 1 out of every 9 or something.
Yeah, also, sorry you live in San Diego. That city sucks.
Does it?
No, it's awesome.
Yeah, especially, I bet, because I heard it's really expensive, but it's hey, awesome. When you got that MD up on your name, bro, you could probably handle a little San Diego's.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's go ahead and thumbs up or thumbs down the food. What do you say?
Let's do it.
What's his name?
Bertram?
Yeah. Mr. Bertram, would you mind? Ooh, thank you. Thumbs up or thumbs down on whether or not you liked, you enjoyed, you might overall get again the biscuit roll-ups, specifically sausage, egg, and cheese. Are you ready? Will you get it again?
Oh!
I will never get that again.
Yeah, I kind of am doing it. The reason I went dead middle is because I was kind of doing it from the perspective of like, I don't like biscuits.
It doesn't look like this, Corey. It doesn't.
I thought it really actually kind of did.
You think it looked like that, bro?
I mean, not the one that you dug all the insides out of. But I thought it was like, here's the thing. Anything with a flaky biscuit, like obviously people like flaky biscuits.
Sure.
Clearly, they wouldn't be making all these if they didn't. I don't like those. So when I eat anything with those flaky biscuits, it's gonna be too bready to me.
Okay.
So I kind of think like, do I really want to say people shouldn't get it? I kind of don't. I wouldn't get it, but I also am under the impression that like, look, if you're one of those people who loves flaky biscuits, or most people like that around, I don't want to steer you away from that. Because I bet if you're into that biscuity, that was actually, I thought, a really flaky, delicious biscuit, if that was your type of thing. I thought it would like hit the spots that if that was your thing, you'd probably like it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of why I went the fit. I didn't go up or down.
I respect
that. Makes sense?
It makes complete sense. I think you need to be horny for biscuits to get this.
Okay.
Like Jimmy Dean has, we've reviewed probably 12 to 15
Most
Jimmy Dean's
amazing.
Things on this show, and we've probably thumbs up 90% of them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of going the same route you went on that one Screaming Sicilian pizza.
Yeah.
This is definitely better than most frozen food breakfast things, but there's so many better Jimmy Dean options that I'm going to thumbs down this one to say kind of skip over this.
I agree with that.
That's kind of my thought.
Yeah, dude.
Let us know in the comments below if you've ever had a biscuit roll up or maybe some of your favorite frozen food breakfast things. We'll look
Ooh.
For them next time we hit up the store in our masks. And we'll see you guys tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday for brand new videos, as we always do every single weekday. Ooh, I gotta catch up. Sure! I'll have a drink next to Mr. Beard Boy.
Cinnamon's tired of my shit.
So am I.